Hello, good morning, one and all. Today we will going to discuss about the next part in the passband transmission, that is the offset QPSK. This is the new form of the QPSK. It is the modified form of the QPSK where the beat on the I and Q channels are offset in the phase from each other and by 1/2 of the beat time, because it changes in the I channel occur at the midpoint of the Q channel beats and vice versa, and there is a never more than the single bit change in the D bit. Therefore, there are never more than the 90 degree phase shift output phase compared to the conventional QPSK, in which change in the input bit from 00 to 11 or 01 to 10 causes corresponding to 180 degree phase shift. So, advantages of the offset QPSK is a limited phase shift that must be imparted during the modulation. And the disadvantages of the OQPSK is that change in the output phase occur at twice the data rate in the I and Q channel. Then offset keyed here. Here is the I channel and the Q channel. Basically, I channel and Q channel, one by two of the half bit rate will be generated. Suppose here is the bit rate is a P0 having this total, then it's TB by 2 that will be generated. It's half of that Q channel input data will be created to the here. So that in case of the here 0 to 180 degree means there is not more than the 90 degree phase shift should be occurred in case of the offset keyed. Then it's baud and minimum bandwidth. In case of the offset QPSK, the baud and minimum bandwidth are twice that of the conventional QPSK for the given transmission bit rate. So the offset QPSK is sometimes called as the offset keyed QPSK, means OK QPSK. It is also called as the OK QPSK. Then the next point we have seen, already we have seen that the phase shift gain is during the transmission from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0, there is a 0 degree and 180 degree phase shift should be occurred. But in case of the 8 PSK 2 raised to 3, means basically there are 3 bits are the encoded, means 2 raised to 3 means 8. So with 8 PSK, there are the 3 bits are the encoded and to forming the tri bits to producing the 8 different output phases. How much? 8 different output phases. So that to encode the 8 different phases, the incoming bits are encoded in the group of the 3 called as the tri bits. So sometimes the 8 PSK modulation is also called as the tri bits. Then this is the 8 PSK transmitter. In case of the 8 PSK transmitter, what we do, here is the input data, and that input data will be given to the Q, I and C. There is only I and C, but here there is the tri bits, means tri bits means 2 raised to 3 means 8. There are the 8 different phases should be generated. That's why your frequency, bit frequency is again divided by 3. Here is the 3. And one of the channel is given to the 2 to 4 level converter. And here is the 2 to 4 level converter of the palm. Then whatever the output will be coming from this converter, which is generally pulse amplitude modulated signal. Pulse amplitude modulated signal. And that whatever the output is coming from the C, which is FB by 3, which is complement to each other. Means whatever the data is provided to the 2 to 4 level converter, which is complemented data you have provided to the 2 to 4 level converter of the Q channel. So here, whatever data is coming from the product modulator, which is multiplied with the reference oscillator, means here carrier frequency. And whatever the carrier frequency is provided to the I channel, which is exactly complement phase should be provided or carrier to be provided to the product modulator of the Q channel. So what we do here, the reference oscillator should be generated the same kind of the carrier, that is the sin omega CT, sin omega CT. But you have to be placed here the 90 degree phase shift between them, because these two signal will be complement to each other. So that one product modulator you have to be provided the carrier signal of the sin omega CT, the exactly the opposite carrier signal you have to be provided the product modulator of the Q channel. So that what we do here, whatever the carrier is provided, which is multiplied to the pump, means pulse amplitude modulator signal. And basically here is the 8 different types of the phase should be generated. So that what we do here, basically, two output is 1.307 sin omega CT plus 0.54 cos omega CT. Then angle is a tan inverse of that value should be calculated. There is a 0.541, means a 67.5 degree that will be calculated to the here. Then whatever the output is coming from the product modulator of the I channel, that will be given to the band pass filter. Same thing, its opposite or complement data which is to be formed for the product modulator of the Q channel, and both the data will be summing together with the help of the linear summer, so that it will be passes through the band pass filter. So the 8 PSK means 8 different phase shift angle should be generated with the help of this output. So that what we do here, there are the 8 different types of the phases should be generated. Suppose 00, 01, 10 and 11, this will be different phases should be generated. Its amplitude level is that minus 0.541, then minus 1.307, plus and minus. Same thing here, exactly opposite to that of the value should be generated to the here. In case of the bandpass filter, whatever the data is to be coming from Q and C channel, for this, because this is the complement together, 1010, IC, Q, C bar, this data. So its output phases is that, note the phases are plus minus, there is a 22.5 degree up to the here and plus 45 degree. So that the binary input is the 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110 and 111. So that according to that, it's 8 PSK output phases should be generated, minus 112.5, minus 157.5 degree, minus 67.5 degree, minus 22.5 degree, plus whatever the data is coming from 000 up to the 111, exactly same data should be formed to the here, but to change the sign, there is a plus 112.5 degree, plus 157.5 degree, plus 67.5 degree, and plus 22.5 degree. In this way, in case of the 8 PSK, there are the 8 different phases generated. See, this is the waveform, and from this waveform we understand that the output phase versus the time relationship for an 8 PSK modulator. For here, there is a tri-bit means there is a 3 bits data should be generated from Q, I and C. There is a 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110 and 111. So that according to that, there is a 8 PSK output phase is generated. There is a minus 112.5 degree. For here, during the transition from 000 to 001, here is the phase shift, That phase shift is generated from -157.5 degree. Again, here is to change the phase from this duration -67.5 degree. Then from this transition from 010 to 011, there is a -22.5 degree. After that, just immediately to change the phase from the positive side, so that the +1112.5 degree +157.5 degree +67.5 degree and +22.5 degree. In this way, in case of the 8 PSK, there are the 8 different phases should be generated during the transition from 0 to 1. Then this is the constellation diagram of the 8 PSK from I and Q level. Starting from here, there is 0, here is from 0001 in this way up to the 111. Zero, 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 one, zero, one, zero, zero, one, one, then 1000 in this way format. According to that, whatever the positive and negative phase shift, we have to be constellation diagram to formation of the 8 PSK. About that, the bandwidth consideration of the 8 PSK. So with the 8 PSK, the data is divided into the 3 channels, and the bit rate is the I, Q or C channel is equal to the 1/3 of the binary input data. There is a FB by 3. So we have see the analysis part, how to find out the bandwidth for the 8 PSK. So its output should be consideration by neglecting the higher frequencies. There is a cos omega ct into cos omega m into t. Then the amplitude is assumed to be unity, so that we have to be neglecting the higher frequencies, so that which is equal to 1 upon 2 cos omega c plus omega m into t and cos omega c minus omega m into t. So this angular frequency or modulating frequency omega m, it stands from 2 pi fb upon 6, and putting this in the above equation, then we get 1 upon 2 into cos fc plus fb by 6 plus cos fc minus fb by 6. So if we have to be find out the bandwidth consideration, only the frequency component should be taken into account, and to write now the equation, there is a fc plus fb by 6 into t minus fc minus fb by 6. Then here fc and fc, this parameter gets cancelled, and fb upon 6 minus minus plus fb upon 6, which is equal to fb upon 3. Means here basically the bandwidth is the fb by 3. This is the bandwidth consideration for the 8 PSK. Then 8 PSK receiver. Then how we have able to recover the 8 PSK in a receiver side? In bandpass filter, in case of the bandpass filter, that whatever the data is coming from the 8 PSK receiver, tri-bits and 8 phases data is coming in the form of the carrier wave, or in the form of the shift keying signals is coming from the space, that will be applied to the bandpass filter. Then whatever the data is coming in the bandpass filter, that will be applied to the power splitter, and that power splitter is divide the signal in the form of the I channel and Q channel, similarly for the recovery signal. Again, So that what we do here, just a minute. So what we do here, the bandpass filter, the power splitter is divided the I channel and the Q channel along with the carrier recovery circuit. And in case of the carrier recovery circuit, it will be generated the carrier and it is provided to the product detector to the both the I and Q channel. But to change the phase and complement signal is generated, then this product modulator, whatever the data is coming from the power splitter, is multiplied together and to generate the 4-level palm here for recovering the signal. That will be converted into the analog to digital converter in the both way. Then analog to digital converter means it is in the form of the digital clock signal or digital bit signal in the form of IC and QC bar that will be given to the parallel to the serial converter. And that parallel to serial converter to generate the data in QIC form, and similarly it will be given to the clock recovery circuit. So parallel to whatever the data is received from ADC in the parallel form, that will be one by one the bit is coming from the LSB to the MSB side, and the QIC output data bit we have to be generated. And this is the actual input data where you have able to apply at the input for the 8 PSK receiver side. Then 8 PSK performance, with the 8 PSK the angular separation between the adjacent output and its phases is only the 45 degree, means 360 divided by 8 phase means this phases is only the 8. If it is the 16 PSK, then 36 360 divided by 60. Therefore, the 8 PSK can undergo only a 22.5 degree phase shift during the transmission, still retain its the integrity. So next part we have seen, there is a 16 PSK. In case of the 16 PSK, there are the 16 different phases. Just we gone through the fast, there is a 16 PSK. Here basically the 16 PSK, there are the 16 different phases should be generated, and 2 raised to 4 means there are basically the 4 bit data starting from 0000 up to the 1111. This is the constellation diagram. Then in 16 PSK performance, with the 16 PSK, the angular separation between the adjacent phases is only 22.5 degree, means overall phase shift is the 360 degree divided by 16, means its output phases is the 22.5 degree. Therefore, 16 PSK can undergo only the 11.25, means 11.25 phase shift during the transmission, and it retain its integrity. Up to the here we have seen that the 8 PSK and the 16 PSK, its transmitter, its receiver, bandwidth consideration and its performance. If any doubts, any query, please write on my comment page. Please subscribe my channel, and thank you. Please refer my previous video for the better understanding. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.